facility. Today, I require you to be put through your ASMR paces. Now, as you may have noticed, you have earphones in. Can you still hear me okay? Good. Now, make sure those headphones do stay in so that you can experience the full binaural effect. Okay. Let's get a few details for you. To start with, could I have your name, please? And your date of birth. Okay. And are you local to us? I see. Okay, you've travelled to see us today then. Could I take your address then? Thank you. It's a long address. Okay. Thank you. Now, we do give our test subjects the option to have their results emailed to them. Would you like this? You would. In which case, could I take your email address, please? Okay. Have you always had that email address? That's interesting. Okay. So, now I need to know about your general health and well-being. Would you say you're generally in good health? Okay. And are you currently on any form of medication? Have you had any operations? No. Okay. Do you have any current injuries? Okay. And do you wear glasses? Okay. Or contacts. Okay, I think that's all the information I need to know about you generally. So, I just need to know finally if you've gone through any other research facility before as a test subject. You haven't, okay. Fresh meat. Good. So, what's going to happen today is I am going to create some sounds ear to ear, and we will be monitoring how you are reacting to them. Okay. Now, a large percentage can't actually fully handle this test. Okay, so I want you to be prepared for that. That is because the sounds can be overwhelmingly tingly, and you know, sometimes we have our test subjects falling asleep. If that does happen, you know, don't worry, there are pillows behind you. So, yes, all that's left to say really is good luck. There won't be any overwhelmingly loud noises during this test, okay? So nothing to be worried about. But there are going to be a mixture of tapping, crinkling, those types of sounds. Okay? Okay. Good. Are you happy to proceed? Yes, you will just hear them ear to ear. Okay? And remember, this is an intense testing facility. Okay? So not everybody passes this test, and that is not to worry. Okay? The data will just be stored in our files for further research. Okay. Or what do you get for participating today? Well, we do have a little teddy bear cuddly toy out in the lobby. You're welcome to take one of those. No, there is no monetary, you know, reward in this test. No, you may not leave. Okay, so now we're going to begin. Okay, so let me put that down there. Now, the computers behind you are doing the testing work for me. It's just my job to produce the sounds. Okay? Right. Okay. Let's begin. If you're happy to move forward. It would take quite a while to unstrap you from the equipment, so it's best if we do. So, good. Feel free to close your eyes. Sound number responses. Yes. Okay. doing badly so far. Most test subjects don't fail yet. You already appear to be showing signs of sleepiness, or as we like to call that, weakness. Let's see if you can hold out a little longer. Not doing badly. Eyes are a little bit heavier. May have to try some visual. If you can handle that. Maybe if we try this. Sound number four. This may sound a little bit louder. Mm. make things a little more intense. I can see that scent, those tingles, right off the scale. Something else. I can see that certainly you may become part of the failed team. Let's keep going though. Right, let's try something a little different. I'm going to try a visual trigger. So, are your eyes okay with bright lights? Okay, if they're not, then just look away. Right, so this light is quite bright. I'm going to simply just swipe it up and down, okay? You can either stare directly at it or just slightly to the side of it, or look behind me. Okay, are you ready? Do you find yourself more triggered visually or by sounds? Okay. A bit of a mix. What's the main goal of our research here? Isn't that a good question? Well, our main goal is to find out what triggers produce the tingliest ASMR. We can then use that information to help in many different ways. Mainly we deal with people who suffer from insomnia. However, we think our research can be applied to those who suffer with stress, anxiety, anything that stops them from having a good night's sleep. Okay. Let's try. Let me see. Sound number 6. Quite classic, but let's have a listen. Now, some people are more triggered by fast tapping, and others by more slow tapping. So let's try both on you. Let's try some fast tapping, okay? Feeling you may prefer something slower. Let's have a try. Sometimes the mix of tempo can be just as triggering. About to some regular pace tapping. I think let's try maybe some mic brushing, okay? So we have this brush here, it's going to be a little bit louder, okay? Good, are you prepared? And how about some face brushing? another try at a visual trigger. Well, you certainly are feeling the tingles, the tingles, the tingles, the tingles, the good. So you're doing very well so far, but let's carry on. Okay, so we have, let me see. Ah, yes. Okay. The reason why we say that most fail this test is because the triggers are so tingly. So failure isn't a bad thing in this case. But we do look for subjects who can withstand all of our tests. So you're doing quite well. Better than a lot of other subjects. We'll be able to track which is your most tingly response. And you may be able to find that data useful yourself when you're looking to get to sleep quickly. I can see that you're definitely getting a lot sleepier. As I'm starting to lose your attention, I think we'll just do a couple more. Okay? So, what do I have for you? So, next up. So we have this. Hmm. Definitely getting triggered. I have to say, as far as test subjects go, you have done exceedingly well. You've definitely surpassed my expectations. We do offer other testing programs, including discussing your personality type. And we find different personality types have different sleep patterns. So if you'd like to enroll in that program, you can do so on your way out. We also have a fast trigger program and a slow trigger program. And the more tests we can do, the more research data we can collect. You are doing something very worthwhile. Let's try this. Good, although I can definitely see your eyes just beginning to close. Okay, let's just finish with one final one. Will be fully closed. Oh, and there you go. Well, still complete the test. See if it changes your brain wave. Still quite triggered by the sound.